We are just 2 days away now from the start of the Steven Spader trial. Last week, attorneys finished selecting the jury that will decide whether the 18-year-old is guilty of murdering Kimberly Cates at her home in Mount Vernon more than a year ago. The panel is made up of 9 men and 7 women, many of them in their 40s and 50s. On Monday, the defense will argue a motion asking the judge to move the trial to another county because of media reports. Our Adam Harding shows us how social media may come into play in what's expected to be one of the most talked about court cases in the state's history.
It was the shocking crime in Mount Vernon that had almost everyone talking. And now, as accused mastermind Steven Spader is slated to go to trial, the courts are hoping that talking quiets down.
Do we think social networking is changing the way we handle business in the courthouse?
Sure, just like it does anywhere. Just like it's changed the way people do business anywhere. It affects every aspect of everybody's life.
Legal analyst Mark Stevens says social networking sites like Facebook and Twitter have become tools for both the prosecution and the defense.
You can see what kind of opinions they have. What do they talk about? What do they think? Because if you think about it, you're trying to get inside the heads of people and learn a little bit about how they process thought and what they're thinking about, what's important to them, what their views are. And a lot of that is just right out there in public.
And with Spader's trial set to start Monday, Stevens says he'd be shocked if attorneys aren't taking the time now to absorb whatever they can about some of the key players in this trial.
It's not just the jurors, but you're going to look at the witnesses to see if the witnesses are making comments about the case. They're instructed not to, too, but they're people, too. There are a lot of civilian witnesses on that list that no doubt have Facebook pages and Twitter pages and MySpace pages.
The courts are very clear from the start. Don't talk about the case whatsoever. But with the advent of social media and its continued growth, there's the possibility your page could be flooded with others' conversations, conversations you're not even involved in. That's one of the reasons legal experts say if you're involved in the case, it's best to close the door on social media. In Manchester, I'm Adam Harding for WMUR News 9.